Well, time for another 64 bypass update. Today is March the 6th, 2017, and today we visit three locations to check the progress of the work going on. And you probably can tell where we are starting out here at the 64 West of Ashboro location, where the bypass begins on the western side of town. There's your map. And we just do a quick flyover. Last Friday, we watched them pouring the concrete here on the half of the bridge. And they informed me this morning that they'll be pouring that other half this coming Friday, along with those end extensions on either end. They'll be doing those also. Maybe working on some of those Thursday. But you notice the concrete that's been poured is covered over with a tarp or some kind of material there. I guess they don't want it to dry out too fast. Want it to cure slowly. So we fly on from here toward Highway 49. We fly out over the work that's going on. I'll speed the video up so you'll see the things start moving faster. Check out the earth moving work going on here on the hillside. These excavators seem to always have something for them to do. They're either digging dirt, loading it in trucks, or they're using them to tend to brush piles, or always have some work for them to do. So we move on out up across the top of the hill here, in amongst all the rock outcroppings. See some activity ahead of us here. Still burning some brush piles, as you can see. We head on out by the old farmstead. I learned that the fire department is going to do controlled burns of the barn and the old farmhouse. Maybe a couple of weeks or so away before they get that done. They have to secure their permits and things from the state so they can do that. We continue flying east on over the rocky hill, across the Highway 49, and take a look down there at the box culvert. Spin around and look back up toward the Klausner Hill, where they're pulling all that dirt off that hill to fill in front of Jayco. We turn and head back toward the farmstead, and we will return back by the bridge and back to 64 here momentarily. We're just taking quick flyovers today. We've got two other sites after this one to take a quick look at. I like the way this land lays all out through here. Of course, they're going to be taking the high spots down and filling in the low spots, I imagine. So they're going to, it's not going to be the dramatic rolling hills that you see there once the road gets built. So we go back over the bridge one last time and load up our gear and go to our second location. I rode down by Highway 42, check on progress there, and the bridge work is continuing there, but it's moving pretty slow. And I just decided not to fly there today, but instead went on over to Pine Hill Road. This fellow here in that pickup truck is in charge of a lot of the bridge work. He told me and told me about progress going on over Pine Hill. So that's where this is. Pine Hill Road bypass crosses between Lee Valley Road and Copperhead Road, as you'll see right here. So right down in there is where this this work is undergoing. They diverted the road over to where they can have space to work on a bridge. I imagine Pine Hill Road will be going up and over the bypass, because on each side it looks like they're digging down low. Gonna have that 64 bypass going underneath Pine Hill Road. I increased the altitude and looked around to see if I could see other work going on, and I did see one little section over here just ahead there. I guess the road's going to be going on out that way, so I flew on over to take a quick closer look at it. I forget the name of that road that's coming by there, but it tees into Pine Hill right here on the left. Those that live in that area know exactly where it is. Flew up around, give a bird's eye view of this intersection, and then turn left on Pine Hill out to where the bypass will be crossing. Fly out over where they're actually doing the work here. Give you a closer look at what's going on. You see they are digging down, lowering the grade there. The roadway will, I'm pretty sure, be going underneath the bridge, Pine Hill. But a box culvert's gonna be built right there. What do you think? Got a stream going across there. Spring is starting to come on, so we're gonna be seeing leaves on all these trees pretty soon. Here's another close-up view of some of their work. This is coming back toward Pine Hill. And that's my car sitting down there. So now we'll move on to our third and final location for this update. It's the I-73-220 bypass, Southmont Extension area. And today I decided to take off from a new location, from Southmont Road, just right by the bridge. Seemed to be a pretty good place to fly from there. That's looking straight on out across where the 64 bypass will be going. So we first fly straight on out. This work and fly on up to the 220 business south. Then we'll come back down Southmont, the new Southmont. A lot of work yet to be done here. There'll be a bridge there also. That's looking back toward town, Ashboro, on 220 business, I believe. Now here we're going back down the new Southmont. I'm calling it the Southmont Extension. I don't know what the correct name for it is. We're on out across where it crosses I-73 220 bypass. They've yet to start putting up the girders for this bridge, but I think it probably won't be too long before they'll start work on that actual bridge there. Looks to me like they've done all the preparatory work for it. Gain some altitude. This is where it ties back into the existing Southmont. We'll turn to the right, fly back up to where I took off from. We'll cross over the bridge, and their work site there is just the other side of the bridge at the bypass there. So that concludes our three locations for today's update. Maybe you got some new views, and appreciate you watching, and we will keep posting as I'm able to film new progress. You have a great day.